I'm Dr. Coleman Martin, a neurointerventional specialist at the St. Luke's Brain and Stroke Institute in Kansas City, Missouri. This is Interventional Stroke Rounds. Today we have a woman in her mid-50s with headaches. Her local physician discovered that she had an aneurysm. We'll walk through the further evaluation and the treatment of her aneurysm. An aneurysm is an outpouching of an otherwise normal blood vessel. We can obtain the best pictures of an aneurysm with an angiogram. Here we're entering our patient's right common femoral artery and advancing a small catheter up the aorta and on to the left internal carotid artery. Through the catheter, we can inject contrast. If we spin the X-ray camera around her head while we inject contrast, we create a three-dimensional view. Here's her aneurysm circled in red. We can transfer these three-dimensional views to a computer, which can in turn create a three-dimensional model of the aneurysm. This allows us to carefully assess the aneurysm and make measurements. An aneurysm at the size and location can press on the nerves as they exit the skull. If an aneurysm like this grows, it could cause bleeding over the surface of the brain, a devastating condition called subarachnoid hemorrhage. Aneurysms can be treated surgically by opening the skull, exposing the base of the aneurysm, and putting a small clip across that base. This aneurysm is being treated with a minimally invasive procedure called coiling. A coil is made of very fine platinum wire. It is soft and flexible, allowing it to pass through a microcatheter all the way from the groin to the aneurysm inside our patient's skull. I have placed a microcatheter inside this glass model of an aneurysm. As I push the coil out of the microcatheter, it fills the space inside the aneurysm. Usually, to entirely fill an aneurysm requires several coils. The coiling process prompts the body to invade the aneurysm with scar tissue. This allows the aneurysm to seal. Let's get back to our patient. This is a magnified view of her aneurysm. The microcatheter is advanced up the left internal carotid artery through the base of the skull, and the tip of the microcatheter is placed inside the aneurysm. I'm pushing the first coil out of the microcatheter and into the aneurysm. The first coil is critical because it forms a frame that holds the additional smaller coils. The coiling is performed under general anesthesia, not because it's painful, but because any movement of our patient's head would blur our images, making the coiling process unsafe. As the coil loops fill the aneurysm, the blood flow in the internal carotid artery begins to bypass the aneurysm. In the interest of time, I'm only showing the placement of this first coil. Now that this first coil is nearly in place, we'll take a picture, checking our progress. Already I can see improvement. Now this is after placing the second coil. And after the third coil, after the fourth coil, and this is after our last coil. One disadvantage of coiling is that the coils, being very soft, can compact. This can allow blood flow back into the aneurysm and, months or years down the road, allow the aneurysm to start growing again. To detect this possibility, it is vital that a patient have follow-up angiography. At St. Luke's Hospital, we perform a follow-up angiogram at the 6-month anniversary of the coiling and again at the 18-month anniversary of the coiling. Let's see how this aneurysm has fared over time. At 6 months, still no coil compaction. At 18 months, the aneurysm still looks fine. At St. Luke's Hospital, we employ the latest techniques in the evaluation and treatment of aneurysms. If you or a family member has an aneurysm, consider coming to see us for a consultation. I hope you enjoyed Interventional Stroke Rounds. Our group is committed to stroke and interventional education. Feel free to share this video on your blog, Facebook, and Twitter. Another stroke, gotta go.